Welcome back, Nick and Lex here. Thank you so much for joining me to another episode of Music with Nick. Today we got a marathon lined up from Jose, and it's going to be a Latin marathon, so mostly Latin jazz. I'm super excited because I'm a huge fan of pretty much all genres of jazz, but Latin jazz is one of them, of course. Fusion jazz, cool jazz, whatever. Whatever the jazzier, the better, I guess. But yeah, so today we got some really cool artists, and even one that I've seen myself with Mario and Alexia live. This was Eddie Palmieri, and it was an honor to see him. This was amazing, the experience here in Denver. We saw him. But let me give you the lineup of this marathon. And I wanted to thank, of course, Jose for this amazing selection. Thank you for sponsoring the marathon. Thank you for making this happen, the video. And I hope you all enjoy. So here we go. So this is, we're going to start it off with Ray Barretto. And this is the song called Oracion, or The Prayer. This is from The Other Road. And this is from 1973, all right? And then we're going to go with Eddie Palmieri. This is Definatelty In from Arete. Arete means earring. This is from 1995. And the third one is the Ironman James. And this is from Jazz on the Latin Side, All Stars, Justo Almario, Alex Acuña, and Donald Vega. And this is from the album The Last Bullfighter. This is 2005. And the last song we're going to do is Tin Deo. This is from Francisco Aguabella, or Aguabella. And the album is Cubacan. Cubacan. This is from 2002. So a lot of fun here. If you're into Latin jazz, you're going to be delighted. I mean, I haven't heard these, but I'm sure it's going to be a lot of fun. So thank you, Jose, for making this happen one more. And I'm going to break character now from professor to reactor. BMAG, really, you hit the nail on that one. So, all right. And also, of course, I did already a video today. I wanted to apologize for my voice. It does sound like a radio host. I'm like, hola, mucho gusto. I'm really under the weather, so yeah. So I was just like, well, you know, I can't change anything. I've tried tea. I have tried everything. I've been sick for the last 6 days. I feel good enough to make videos. I'm drinking water and I'm drinking coffee, so it's all good. You know, I'm taking medicine, so don't worry. All right, so let's hit it off with Ray Barretto and the Oracion. Here we go. Enjoy. Thank you. Beautiful sax, beautiful. It's not over, but holy moly, what a great piece. You know, I wish I could have waited and done this with Mario. I haven't done any reactions with Mario yet. Because he's so busy, you know, and I'm busy and Alexia's busy, and we're always like trying to find time to spend. But this would have been amazing because he appreciates it so much. Like, I loved the sax, the trumpet, the unison, the harmony of the sax and the trumpet. The flute solo was beautiful. Everything, and then it got really chaotic there. But if you can look through the chaos and find the beauty of jazz, that's when you know what you're listening to. Because it's not chaotic. It's all improvisation, and it's all basically calculated to work flawlessly. And there is no chaos in jazz, you know, that's the beauty. And it's just, I don't know, you know, you just understand after a while, you know, of listening, that it's not random notes, it's all intention, you know. So it's beautiful. This is really, really good. I just love the whole intro. The percussions are beautifully laid on, and the melody, you know, just the way the sax comes in. I think the trumpet came in first. I don't remember. That's why I love the pause, but beautifully played. Beautiful. They're going back into, I think they just, you know, finished with their, the cacophony that comes, you know, and then, so let's continue. Let's continue. This is really cool. Gracias, Jose. Instrument here, this piano, reminds me a lot of Vangelis. Very cool, like Blade Runner, you know, that neon, the neon detective. It's like noir. I wanted to say neon, not neon. Neon because the colors. That noir, that detective noir, you know, sound of Blade Runner. That also has a lot of sax, and such a great... Guys, if you want to listen to some great jazz in a movie setting, watch Blade Runner. It's really, really amazing. What a track. So if Mario doesn't know this yet, I would be surprised, because he's obviously very much into Latin jazz. But I mean, there's always a song that can be, you know, a little bit older or, but okay. But I'll definitely play it to him. So now we're going to switch to Eddie Palmieri. And talking of Mario, we had the great pleasure, and I thank him so much for this opportunity that he took us, Alexia and me, and the entire family, and we watched Eddie Palmieri perform live I don't know exactly the venue, but it was outside of Denver, not exactly in Denver downtown. It was, I don't recall, but it's part of the Denver area outside. So really, really cool. So we're going to play Definatelty In from the album Arete, and here we go. To stop because I have to talk. This is so good. I just love all the improvisations, obviously, and it remembers me so much of living in Mexico. So we did have one Cuban bar on the Malecón. The Malecón is a boardwalk, and there's all these discos, and there's all this basically restaurants, you know, for people on vacation. It's very expensive there. It's not really designed for the people that live there because it's quite expensive. But I remember I would always sneak into this bar called La Bodeguita del Medio. And I wouldn't buy anything because I would just wanted to listen to the music. I would just stand at the door and then they would tell me, hey, you can come in and just like listen to the band. And it was just like because they were playing like this Cuban jazz, and it was the only place they would do it. And so I was very intrigued. And it just reminds me so much. They had like the real deal, you know, musicians from Cuba and Puerto Rico and all this good stuff. So they would play a lot of salsa, merengue. And it was just like basically, it was just, I was just getting aware of this music. Why does it sound so tropical, you know, and so really cool. Because I had, of course, I would listen to a lot of jazz. When my dad was living in the house, he would play a lot of jazz. But he would play some like Latin jazz, but I think more like cool jazz, you know, like Stan Getz and stuff like that, Miles Davis and stuff like that. But yeah, so it just reminds me a lot when I would like go out, you know, and then listen to my, like discover my music, that would become pretty much my favorite musical genre. Along with like progressive rock and, you know, jazz fusion, which is basically my favorite genre. But yeah, so good. All these improvisations of the trumpet and then the sax, and then there was, I think, some other kind of sax or trumpet, and then the piano and the bass. It's beautiful. So Eddie Palmieri is just on a different level. So let's go back and listen to, let's resume. That solo at the end, that, you know, percussion, that was amazing. I mean, I remember once in, on one of the new, like, New Year's, I don't really remember what year, but I was staying in Sayulita, and they handed me one of this, I don't know what it's called, one of those, you know, gongas or something like that. I think it was a gonga, or it was smaller, and I just like started playing and soloing like this, like that, and then there were, and actually they told me like, hey, you're really good, man. How long have you been playing? And I'm like, it's my first time. I guess I had a musical knack, you know, for just improvisation. I'm a terrible drummer. I've tried to play the drums. I can't do it. It's just, I can't, you know, do that whole octopus stuff. It's just, I admire it very, very much, but I can't do it. It's, maybe if I tried harder, but I think string instruments are my thing. And I really want to start playing the sax. If I'm honest, I'm just, I think too cheap to buy a sax. Because what if I don't like it? Maybe I should borrow one, you know. And but drumming is just like, that's a whole different animal. You have to have, yeah. You know, you drummers, all you drummers know, and all you musicians know. Okay, Iron Man James, the last bullfighter. We're going to do, this is from Jazz and the Latin side of All Stars. Justo, let me see. I do need my glasses for that. Well, I read it at the beginning, so I can't read it anymore. So here goes Iron Man James. Amazing. I mean, this vamp he was playing. This, I don't know how many bars, and the guy's just like with the sax. And then, it's so freaking cool. You know, I wish I could like play like that, honestly. Really, Latin jazz is so good, man. It takes time, you know, it takes time to get into it. It's very complex because it's just different, you know, from other kinds of jazz, but it's once you get into the vibe, wow, man, I wish I could play over like that, you know, that rhythm. Okay, let's keep going. This is really good. Thank you, Jose. This is wonderful. I love it.
Thank you.
the fun they're having. I mean, it's literally you don't see them on the audio, but I mean, you can feel. And then as a musician myself, I know how much fun this must be causing them. It's such a cool, it's really a hard lifestyle to be a musician, because I've done it myself. In Puerto Vallarta, I was playing, you know, in restaurants and bars, and I mean, it's a good life, you know. You make a lot of money, especially when you're living in a vacation like center like Puerto Vallarta. So we are making like good money, like, but it's also like the thing about this whole the downside is then when September comes, like October, like September, October, like August, September, October, it's like dead. Like you make no money. So that's the problem. And that's why I was basically also like struggling, because I mean, nobody wants to hire you. There's no people. It's too hot, you know? So you have to basically do it in a place where it's always the same, you know, like LA or like California is a perfect place that's always kind of warm and you can play every night. So in Mexico, it was just not ideal. And I've always wanted to do like the whole like go on a cruise ship and play, but I never kind of like could, because I was just in charge of taking care, you know, of my parents and stuff. So yeah, that kind of like went downhill. But yeah, I mean, just like it feels so great to be able to play and to put like thousands of hours into the instrument, and you know, and it's just amazing. Like to be, being a musician is really something that I'm proud of and that I cherish every day of my life. And I take good care of my hands, you know, I try my best. And yeah, so, but it's just such a, it's so amazing to be able to play. And I love that I'm basically right now, like I'm teaching Alexia as best as I can with a lot of patience for her to play. And she's so talented, you know, she's so talented. And she's slowly, and it's hard to grab an instrument, you know, it's just very difficult and challenging to start playing an instrument. It's intimidating, you know. And so, but she really has so much talent, and I love that every time she grabs the instrument, she's making a lot of she's basically having a lot of success, you know. Like she plays better every time she touches the guitar, and it makes me so happy. So yeah, I mean, she doesn't want to get to that level. She doesn't have the desire. I'm sure it's going to grow to get into the whole, like, you know, virtuoso thing. But right now she's happy with chords and, you know, so. But we'll see more of Alexia with the instrument. All right, so let's go now. We're going to do Tin Deo by Cubacan. And this is Francisco Aguabella. Let's go.
signatures are so it's so good. Oh my god, I can't believe it. It's just ridiculous how good this is. Really, Jose, thank you, because this is man, I hope I get more jazz reactions. You, to all you jazz freaks, you know, send me jazz, man, requests. This is a lot of fun. It's just, you know, a lot of stuff gets, like, when you listen to jazz, a lot of stuff can get lost because there's so much happening. But with these headphones, they're so good. And I love these headphones. And it's so spot on. Everything is being received here. So I love it. So that when I start counting and then I'm, and I tend to do that even though I'm not a drummer, but I just count music. When I play music, I'm always counting. Even when I play, I have like my own little metronome in my mind. So it's really hilarious when I'm counting and then, and these time signatures come up and it's like, what are they doing? It's really, really hard to do and to keep in time and then to stay on the ball game. It's really hard music. Like, it's, they're not screwing around, so. Thank you so much, Jose. This was a blast. I hope everybody enjoyed as much as I did. I mean, how can you not dance, you know, to this? And it's a lot of fun, man. Thank you so much. My first ever Jazz Marathon. Thank you, Jose. I do appreciate it very, very much from the bottom of my heart. This was a lot of fun. I love how you guys always come up with new ideas. You know, Narvik and RJ and Greybeard and Rudy, and you all have all these crazy ideas, and you know, it's so cool. And thank you for the support and for being in the comment section and, you know, just like supporting the channel. And we get more viewers every day, and because of you guys, you know, because of the music you choose. And sometimes it's the most obscure tune, or sometimes it's the famous thing, you know, but we keep the old and new music alive, and that's what we basically try to do, you know, from the start. Alexia and I, we just wanted to listen to music again, and it's a really a great journey that we're having, and it has changed our lives, and we're happier people, you know, and we make you guys happy too, and that's like just such a great payoff, you know. It's such a blessing. And we thank you from the bottom of our hearts for all this love and support and everything you guys do. So I hope you did enjoy. I loved it. Thank you, Jose. Everybody, let me know in the comment section what you thought of this. Is this your, you know, is this something you would consider listening? Have you been a jazz, a Latin jazz fan all your life or just recently? Let me know what you think, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.